Hey, hey everyone. We've all come across a situation where we've tried to make a change in a spreadsheet, type in a few different new numbers, and a pop-up appears to say, you cannot make a change, this sheet is protected. So the first thing you'd usually do, you'd go up into the ribbon tab, go to review, and press unprotect sheet. That would usually do the trick, unless there's a password. So it'll pop up with a, what is the password? I'll try and remember, press okay, and it's not correct. I've forgotten what it is. What do I do now? Well, there is a trick to do this. I'll show you very, very quickly. And if you like what you see, please click that like button or subscribe to the channel. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is to save a file or save a copy just in case we make a mistake and we need to start again. So file, save as, and instead of vehicle details, we'll call it vehicle details copy. And press save. Now we have two sheets in this document and we just got to remember that it's sheet one or the first sheet that I'm making the changes to where I want to unprotect the document. So I'm going to shut this file down and now within the file explorer I can see that vehicle details copy. So I'm going to change the extension of this from an Excel file to a zip. And to do this you've got to make sure that the extensions are visible. If you can't see them, you go up into view and make sure the file extensions file name extension is ticked. So I'm going to right click this file, rename, change the XLSX into zip and press enter. Am I sure I want to change it? Yes, I am. And now I'm going to open up that zip file, go into the Excel file and down to worksheets. And if you remember, I had two sheets in my document. It's sheet one that I need to change, but it won't reference the same name that you've changed it to. And that's just the way it is in the back end of the zip file. So I'm going to take a copy of that sheet one, copy, and just paste it back into my original file section. And there it is. And now I'm going to make the changes to this sheet one. And it's really simple. You just right click, open with Notepad, and it comes up with this code. It looks very complex, but it's as simple as trying to find where the protection is. And it's and you select Control F to find, type in protect, and you can see it's found this sheet protection section. So right at the beginning where this opened pointed bracket is, we're going to copy this section or highlight this section, sorry, and drag across till we find that closed pointed bracket. The first time we see that closed pointed bracket, make sure we don't delete anything outside of this. Select and delete. Simple as file and save. And shut it down. So now we've got the new sheet one XML file that we want to put back into the zip file location. So we're going to right click, copy, go back into the zip file, Excel, worksheets, and we're going to paste over the top of this sheet one. Right click, paste. Copy and replace the file that's in there currently. And we are done. So we can actually go back to the files and rename this back to an Excel file from zip. Right click, rename, and we'll change that zip file back into XLSX and press OK. Are you sure? Yes. So now I've got the new file with the updated change. I'm going to simply open that new file and it looks exactly the same as it did before. However, when I make changes to the numbers, I can do that and that protection pop-up doesn't appear. So it's really handy. Hope that was useful. I'll see you next time.